Good morning, I'm Eric Scott. This is New Jersey's first news for Friday, November 17th. It's made possible by the Bet Parks Casino and Sportsbook app. One more really terrific weather day today. There should be an abundance of sunshine and temperatures could hit 70 degrees away from the coast today. But then we've got some changes coming for the weekend. Our chief meteorologist Dan Zarrow says it will be decidedly colder on Saturday and Sunday. Might even be a bit breezy. Will there be rain? Full forecast details are available on air, online at nj1015.com and on our free mobile app. Inflation is hitting all of us hard in New Jersey, but some harder than others. There is a new report that is looking at who is more likely to use goods and services that are rising the most in price and the ability of residents to absorb these rising costs. Not only did Hispanic and Black households experience more inflation, consuming more of the products and services that increased the most, but they also earn less in general and are less equipped to take on the inflation. The report finds women also faced a higher overall inflationary burden. Automatic toll increases again in the Garden State. They'll take effect at the Port Authority crossings in January. 63-cent increase. It's based on inflation. Fares on the AirTrain at Newark Airport also indexed for inflation. They will also rise. Trips will cost 25 cents more. Again, this all starts January 1st. The food delivery service DoorDash can now bring you booze. Jersey consumers who use DoorDash can toggle to the alcohol tab on the app, browse and order from a wide selection of adult beverages. There are restrictions, however. They cannot deliver to high-risk areas like college campuses, other areas where underage drinking could be present. Also cannot deliver to hotels. All of the rules and regulations for DoorDash booze delivery at nj1015.com this morning. A South Brunswick man is recovering after being attacked by a dog, a Rottweiler, as he got his mail Tuesday in South Brunswick. At the scene, police placed a tourniquet on the 70-year-old victim's arm to prevent him from bleeding to death. The dog has been quarantined, the owners issued a summons, and the investigation continues. The Motor Vehicle Commission is warning of a new scam that is targeting New Jersey drivers. If you get an email or a text that is asking you to validate your driver's license, don't click on it. A notice on the MVC website reads, "These emails and texts do not originate from the NJMVC and may be part of a scam." More on that scam and how to protect yourself at nj1015.com this morning. A popular music venue down the shore that has been closed due to flooding now will not reopen. Operators of the House of Independence in Asbury say the damage is just too great, over $500,000. House of Independence was among the most popular venues for local bands. The owners say they are looking for a buyer. The first permanent national memorial for COVID victims is having an event this weekend. Saturday, November 18th, 4 p.m. to 7 p.m. at the IBEW Local 400 in Wall Township. Rami's Heart National COVID Memorial is in honor of Rami Swan, who died from COVID at the age of 40 in May of 2020. The event is to help fellow grievers get into the holiday spirit. Besides food and Santa, vendors will be present for holiday shopping. Some are fellow grievers who lost a loved one to COVID and have developed a small business in honor of them. Have something to say about our top stories? Leave your comments right here. Please like and share this video. And remember, we're always taking your calls, talking Jersey on air on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's New Jersey's first news for this Friday, November 17th, made possible by the Bet Parks Casino and Sportsbook app. Have a safe and a happy weekend.